Hello everyone, in this video, I'll demonstrate how to use the KS test fixture, which can test hashboards like the KS3M, KS3L, KS0 from IceRiver Miner. Let's first get familiar with it, and some accompanying cables and tools. Here's the KS Universal Tester. This is the hashboard cable, used to connect the test fixture, and the hashboard. These two are DuPont cables, used for connecting the tester to this USB to TTL serial port module. It will be connected to a computer to display test logs. Now, let me introduce several of its main interfaces. This is the powering interface. It runs on a 12 volts DC supply. This interface is for connecting the ribbon cable to the hash board. Here is the communication interface for connecting the DuPont cables. We also need to use an APW3++ PSU to power the tester. Then, use an adjustable PSU to power the hash board. Set the voltage to 12 volts, and the current to 31 amperes. Additionally, we will use a computer to display test logs, and a cooling fan to cool the hash board. Today, we will demonstrate how to use the test fixture with a KS3M hash board. Let's connect the related cables. First, insert the DuPont cables into the three pins on the right side of this interface. We don't need to distinguish colors. Just plug them in directly like this. Then connect the other end to the USB to TTL serial port module, paying attention to the connection order. The blue cable corresponding to pin 3 goes into the TXD pin. The green cable corresponding to pin 2 goes into the RXD pin. The yellow cable for pin 1 needs to be connected to the GND pin. Make sure not to connect incorrectly. Continue connecting the ribbon cable, which needs to be plugged into the far right interface. Connect the 12 volts power cable. Place the hash board on the cooling fan. Then connect the ribbon cable and the adjustable PSU power cable. Finally, plug the USB into the computer. Alright, the test environment is successfully set up. We also need to set the related parameters and test software on the computer. Open Computer Management, find Device Manager. Click on Ports, and we can see the USB port is COM7. Double-click to open it. Click on Port Settings. Set the parameters as shown. Now open the testing software. Click on Session. Then Serial. Choose Serial Port as the just noted COM7. Also select the parameters 115200 as before. Setup is complete. Then sequentially turn on the adjustable PSU, the cooling fan, and the APW3++ PSU. We can see the KS test fixture has begun testing the hash board. Okay, the test results are displayed. These show the temperature and voltage of each ASIC chip. The PCB1 temp displays the temperature data of the temperature sensing chip, and then we can sequentially see the temperature, voltage, and signal of the ASIC chips. When we see 3 success on the testing interface, it indicates that the hash board is fault-free. The above is the specific method of using the KS test fixture. If you have any questions, please leave a message in the comment area.